Oh my god. Does it keep putting me all the way down here? Fucking museum stuff. Fucking making that noise. No, you fucker. Of course I die. I always die. I'm just a fucking... Well, I'll be better. No. Not be having this much trouble. Only 5,800. I lost fucking. Magic shrouding cracked here. Lightning shrouding. Shrouding cracked here. Holy shrouding cracked here. Alright, let's see what these things I can't even use. Temporary boost magic attacks and mixed physique. crystal tear forms slowly over the ages where the arid tree's bounty falls to the ground. Can be mixed in a flask of wondrous physique. The resulting concoction temporarily boosts the power of one's magic attacks. Lightling shroud, cracked tear. Crystal tear forms slowly over the ages where the arid tree's bounty falls to the ground. Can be mixed in a flask of wondrous physique. The resulting concoction temporarily boosts the power of one's lightning attacks. Holy shrouding, cracked tear. Crystal tear forms slowly over the ages where the arid tree's bounty falls to the ground. Can be mixed in a flask of wondrous physique. The resulting concoction temporarily boosts the power of one's holy attacks. So I gotta get through the castle to get to that tower. From a bristly pelt worn by ancestral followers. Ancestral followers keep their distance from the earth tree, awaiting new buds. They are certain to sprout from their very flesh, and indeed their souls. Logar militia armor. Armor worn by lean, mean, and filthy militiamen. Freshly singed battlegrounds, infusing with the stench of the dead. Forbidden lands that will be excised from the memory of history. This is where the vulgar militia serve as untiring on some watchkeeper. recruitment worn by ancestral followers, raises robustness. Robustness governs resistance to blood loss and frost. Said to be a budding horn, the ancestral followers believe that the horn of a long-lived beast continued to bud his blood-like antlers over and over again until the beast one day became Stalwart Horn Charm, an recruitment accoutrement. Stalwart Horn Charm, accoutrement worn by the ancestral followers, raises robustness. Robustness governs resistance to blood loss and frost. Said to be a budding horn, ancestral followers believe that the horns of the long-lived beast continue to bud like antlers over and over again until the beast one day becomes an ancestral spirit. old aristocrat ground. Gown of soft cloth adorned with fine gold embroidery. Travel attire worn by nobles in the capital. Garb favored by the aged. Abandoning their birthplace after the shattering, these undead wanderers are the pitiful product of unending life. Have a moment without dying. Just no, it has to be where I've already been, right? Where the fuck did I die at?
You're tarnished, aren't you? I welcome you to the Church of Vows. I am Miriel, steward of this sacred chamber. My apologies for the unseemly state of affairs. Do you know the origin of this place? How it came to be known as the Church of Vows? Well, that is a shame. But who can blame you? The shattering has caused us, all of us, to lose sight of something very dear. It is here, at the Church of Vows, that the great houses of the Erd Tree and the Moon were joined by the matrimonial bond between red-haired Radagon and Renala of the Full Moon. And so our church holds in view the monuments of both houses, the Erd Tree of the capital and the Academy of Rhea Lucaria. Oh, was there something you needed? You are free to show yourself around. I would serve as your guide, only my legs aren't what they used to be. If you find anything of use, you are free to take it with you. Unless, perhaps, you are in search of instruction. In which case, I will share all that I know. Is there something else? You wish to know more of Lord Radagon. Lord Radagon was a great champion, possessed of flowing red locks. He came to these lands at the head of a great golden host. When he met Lady Renala in battle, he soon repented his territorial aggressions there and became husband to the Carian queen. However, when Godfrey, first Elden Lord, was hounded from the lands between, Radagon left Renala to return to the Erd Tree capital, becoming Queen Marika's second husband and King Consort, taking the title of Second Elden Lord. The mystery endures to this day as to why Lord Radagon would cast Lady Renala aside, and moreover, why a mere champion would be chosen for the seat of Elden Lord. You wish to know more of Lady Renala. She is queen, head of the Carian royal family, and governor of the Academy of Rhea Lucaria, the great and beautiful Full Moon Witch. Sadly, her heart was broken when Lord Radagon left her. And then, when the Academy rebelled against the royals, she was locked away in the Grand Library. Oh, what have we here? Very well, let us both learn together. Heresy is not native to the world. It is but a contrivance. All things can be conjoined.